Hi guys, welcome to Travelers number 6. I'm glad that you are watching.
Elias, that's not how you wear your mask. Anyways, guys, we have more on the poster screen.
Primrose, I think you might need a lesson on wearing your mask. Guys, we also have some toaster noodles to show you, so thank you to everybody who sent one in.
That's gonna cause some problems. I don't think that's how it's meant to be. But anyway, today we've got Zoe's favorite song coming up, which is super cool. I know you'll enjoy that. But yeah, let's get on with the show.
Travelers.
It's
the
Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and he was buried.
He descended to the grave. And on the third day, he rose again from the dead.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty.
He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Universal Church, the fellowship of believers. We have learned many things from the Apostles' Creed, and I hope, guys, that you are memorizing it and that you're planting these words deep into your heart, because they're important. It's important for us to know what we believe and to understand what we believe and to be able to defend what we believe as Christians as well. We're going to meet many people who don't believe what we believe. Maybe they're from another religion, or maybe they just want to argue and say that what we believe is wrong. And we need to know what we believe and why we believe it, so that we can defend and that we can have a strong foundation that we can stand on as Christians. So this stuff is really, really important. And our two lines this week are very simple. It says, I believe in the Holy Universal Church and the fellowship of believers. I wonder if you think it's a bit strange that the creed is saying, we believe in the church. I mean, is that not obvious? Maybe you think that it isn't really important to believe in the church. Well, it's just the building that's down the road, or it's just the place that we gather on a Sunday and a Friday. But actually, at the moment, we're not going to that place, are we? We're not gathering physically as we normally would for church on a Sunday and Friday because of lockdown. And I think lockdown has helped us a little bit to understand a little bit more about what the church actually is. And here we see, right, coming towards the end of the Apostles' Creed, a statement of belief in the church, because belief in the church is really important. I think this lockdown has helped us to understand what the church is, and also shown us how important it is to really believe in the church. The church is a gift from God to us as believers, so that we can fellowship as Christians, which is the second line of our creed. The creed describes the church as holy, and we are holy, we are made holy, we are set apart because of what Christ did on the cross for us. So we are set apart as the church of Christ. But the creed also says that the church is universal. Now, I think we know what that word means. It means that it is right across the globe. The church is everywhere. We're going to find churches in China. We're going to find churches in France. We're going to find churches in Mongolia. We're going to find churches in Ethiopia, and any country that you want to mention, we are going to find churches there, because the church is universal. Everywhere there exists at the church of God. And this is how God, the church, is how God has organized his people to be a witness to the world and for them to fellowship together. The church is God's gift to us as Christians. Imagine if there was no church. And we were all followers of Jesus, but we were all doing it alone. It would be so difficult. We'd have no encouragement from other people. We'd have nobody to sing with together. We'd have nobody to study God's word together. We'd have no leaders to look up to. And the church is God's gift to help us, to organize us into a community of believers. The church functions as it meets together around the word of God, as it celebrates the sacraments together, that's as it baptizes people into the church, as it breaks bread, as it has communion together. And the church functions as it worships together, as it prays together. And all those things are the ways that the church comes together to function. As it gathers together, normally, physically, but at the moment, we're doing it online. As that gathering takes place, we're looking back to what Jesus did for us on the cross. But we're also looking forward to the hope that we all have as God's people, as believers in Jesus Christ, the hope of life eternal. And we're functioning in the here and now in the power of the Holy Spirit. And that is how the church functions. Church is important, and expressing a belief in the church is very important for us as Christians. It's important that we remember this. It's important that we understand this. And it's important that wherever we are, wherever we end up as Christians, that we are members of our local church, that we are engaged together around God's word, around the sacraments, singing together and praying together as God's people, strengthened in that fellowship and also functioning as part of God's gift to us, the church. So I hope this week, as we've read these lines and we thought about these lines, it's encouraged you to be committed to attending St. Mark's online every single week, and to committed to being committed to the church as you grow up and as you go forward. So that's the two lines of the Apostle Creed that we've learned today. I believe in the Holy Universal Church and the fellowship of believers.
Hi, so my favorite Christian song is probably Marching On, because it reminds us about how God is the banner that we raise in the chaos, and that the gates of our world stand against us. And I just really, really like it, because we sang about God's word last, and we got to sing it every day.
Are you ready, Belfast?
Put a smiley face on if you like, but this is how it'll look unless you want to toast it for longer to make it even more.
Hi, James. What did you make with your toast doodle?
I made a bat and ball.
Cool.
Joining us for another episode of Travelers Online. It really has been a huge adjustment. It's been difficult for us not seeing you. It's been difficult for you not meeting together. I know that I really miss playing games and chatting with you guys and just things being normal. But it's been great doing this. I'm enjoying it. So thank you for joining us for this episode. Have a good week. Hopefully see you soon. But we'll definitely see you in the next episode. And let me close in prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank you so much that you brought us through another week, Lord. I thank you that you have given us the strength to make it through some really difficult times. I ask that you'll continue to strengthen our youth, help them as they get ready to go back to school. Some of them are back at school, some of them will be going back soon. And it's not fun being back at school wearing a mask.
all day. It's exhausting not being able to play with their friends, hug their friends. So Lord, I ask that you will give them energy and strength and creativity as they play outside, help them to find ways to maybe play on with their shadows instead of being able to actually play normal on. Help them to be creative and come up with fun ways to still enjoy themselves, especially at school. And yeah, Lord, we do just ask that you'll help us to remember safety at all times, wearing our masks properly, and yeah, protecting each other, Lord. Will you keep us safe from this coronavirus? Will you bring us all back together soon so that we can have travellers back at St. Mark's Church soon? Yes, Lord, we do also ask that you'll help Naomi to get back safely. And yeah, that we'll all really be able to fellowship together and enjoy being the Travellers Youth Group together again. We ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks, guys, so much. We'll see you again soon. Bye.